Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Today, we've got a Week 8 matchup on tap here, as it'll be the Los Angeles Rams taking on the Dallas Cowboys. Lurching closer toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Now, before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Here we go. 11, Thomas. 12.
Here's Burrow to throw right away. This one swung out here to Jones. 5 yards on the game's first play. Second down.
11.
Burrow will throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Perry. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Good work after the catch. Gets him 15 and a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
11.
Throwing now, Burrow on first down. They bring him down.
Gotta go score.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle is going to be made at the Rams 39. Now Burrow changing things up here.
11 MT.
Good for a Cowboys.
They'll look to throw here on first down. He'll go right back to St. Brown. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. The quick throw by Burrow is complete. Touchdown! Chris Godwin, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining. Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. Blitz coming and down he goes. Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Tua gonna throw. To the right side and he's got more complete. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. It'll be a first down for the Rams there on a pickup of 18.
I don't care who you put on him. He's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man. Maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Here we go.
So
here
from
we go.
The 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. And they'll go with a ground attack here. In on the stop, the former Georgia Bulldog, Roquan Smith. You look at this Cowboy defense. And they've shown the ability to play tough against the pass, currently ranked number 9 in the NFL.
Yeah, defending the pass hasn't been an issue for them. It's been stopping the run. And if they don't stop the run, they can't get back to their strength, which is guarding against the air attack.
Ready?
From the 42-yard line, here's the second and 8.
Black Ultra. Blaster, 6.
Back to throw. Hooper. And this thing is blown out defensively. They will not get a throw off on the trick play. And that'll go down as a sack.
Buried for the sack by big Jalen Carter. So now make that a second sack for them on this drive.
And Brandon, we hear it every week when we go out to do a game. Everyone talks about playing complimentary football. Their offense goes down and scores. They see that, and they want to back them up, and that they did, getting 2 sacks on this first drive.
The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. After the delay, they're backed up even further for third and long. Here's Tua. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Roquan Smith, and they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
On 2. 11 mighty. 11 mighty. 11 MT. Tate.
Flag comes in. This might be a free play. Into the hands of Perry, complete. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. They knew they had the free play after the penalty. They get great yardage, so they can decline that penalty.
And one of the things we've seen develop more and more in recent years, our team seeing that penalty occur and still taking the big shot down.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Jackson, Smith, and Jigba. From 4 yards out. And the Cowboys are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that'll make the score 14-0. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. The L.A. offense ready to go for their next drive. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So, they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
Second and 6, just inside the 30.
21G.
Looking to pass. Tua. He'll get this underneath to Montgomery. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Tagovailoa. A throw out wide, going to be incomplete.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Okay. Now a second and 10. Moore, the man in motion.
All right, let's go.
From the gun, it's Tua. And his throw is incomplete.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit two of his first five passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
In motion left goes Cooks. Tua setting up shop to throw again. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 43. That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 43. And they'll run it here. And that is well read there defensively. He was looking to use his speed to get the edge, but they said no way. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Moore, the man in motion. Tua wants to throw it on second down. He'll get this to his tight end, Gesicki. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 29-yard line. They'll try the middle with Montgomery. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Tua. It's caught by Hooper. Touchdown, LA. Austin Hooper, his first touchdown on the year. And the Rams are back within a score.
When we draw up defenses on the board, we do account for every receiver. But on that particular play, somehow he was wide open, became an easy touchdown pass.
The point after, goodbye groupie. And that'll make our score 14-7. Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. And somewhat surprisingly, a fair catch called for on the short kick, so no return. And they'll begin at the 25-yard line.
Here we go.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And you figure this should be a healthy, arrested, a focused unit, and they're working on a good winning streak. They had the week off last week. This is really a team, Charles, that should be in top form.
I would agree absolutely with that. What coaches worry about, what organizations worry about, though, is overconfidence. They've been playing so well, and now they've had that extra time off. And we've seen teams come back off the open week and come out flat. So what a lot of good coaches do is they kind of game plan for that with their teams. On defense, they may blitz more in the beginning to get them going. On offense, they may go more up tempo. Anything to get them out of that lethargy right at the beginning.
On second down, Burrow. That is caught. It's Chris Godwin. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 43. Now it's Burrow. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete. The Cowboys at 5-1 here in this early part of the season. And they come in with fresh legs. They got the extra time off thanks to an early season open week.
And usually your hope is that your open week comes a little bit later in the year. But when you get a chance to get your fresh legs back, you have to take that time and run with it. And that's what they're trying to get done here.
Throwing again, it's Burrow. Completes it to Perry. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 20-yard line. They go play action with Burrow. He finds Smith and Jigba. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. 12 more yards there and another first down. Now Burrow changing the look. Gets this one quickly out wide. Touchdown, Cowboys! A.T. Perry, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Cowboys go up by 2 touchdowns. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And it's now 21-7. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And he'll elect not to run with it. The fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line.
Ready.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. A strong showing their last time out. They scored the touchdown, but Charles, they look up and they're still down double digits, so you feel like just to keep pace, this drive probably needs to end in the end zone as well.
Yeah, and I think the best move for them is to not worry about how far they are down on the scoreboard, but to just remember the last drive and how it ended. Go ahead and try and repeat that. Then you can look at the scoreboard and see where this game is.
And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. A penalty accepted, and they move the ball forward. Setting to throw on first down is Tua. Well, a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete.
Well, this defense is going to have to finish the job. There's still a second half that they have to play. But so far, an absolute total effort. They've disrupted the passing game, stressed the pocket for the quarterback. They forced him into errant throws. Everything they're doing has been executed well.
Solo left Zion.
Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Throw left side complete. That's Moore. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4. Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. Tua sets up to pass it. Oh, everything falling apart now. Another one intercepted. Picked off by Roquan Smith. And the Cowboys are going to have it here just past the 25.
Here we go.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And now consider the lead. The question is, how much is good enough? Are you going for more?
It's the NFL. There's never enough, I believe, because they get reeled in all the time when you sit on the ball. I think that they will try and move the ball downfield and try and squeeze a few more points out of this first half. They'll be careful. They'll be a little bit cautious at times. But also, they will attack downfield and try and get in position for at least 3 points.
They will throw on first down with Burrow. Left side, he finds Smith and Jigba. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route. And he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. From the red zone now, here's Burrow first down. And this one incomplete, threw it down at the feet of his receiver. That is the first time that they've targeted him that he has not come down with a catch.
He's caught everything that's been thrown his way. A dominant pass receiver that can break down any defense, because when he's doing that kind of work, it really hurts you on the back end.
And even though it's an incompletion there, I think they're going back to that well. This is caught. Touchdown. Jackson Smith and Jigba in the final seconds of the first half. And the Cowboys will extend their lead here just before halftime. And now it's blocked. And thankfully, the offense able to recover, but the extra point attempt foiled. 4 seconds, all that remain here this first half as the kick gets away. The L.A. offense ready to go for their next drive. And with only 4 seconds on the clock, time likely for just one snap of the football. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. The Rams set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail here as we resume play. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line. The L.A. offense ready to go for their next drive. Well, they look up at the scoreboard facing that deficit. A 3-score game, Charles, but look, there's plenty of time to go here. The old football cliche that comes to my mind is you can't get it all back at once. They probably need something, though, out of this drive, at least 3 points.
Are you trying to say that there's no 3-score drive on that play sheet for any of those coordinators? They just don't have it, right? You're trying to get it all back. You know you can't get it back in one drive. But maybe cut into it a little bit, as you just suggested. Try and create a little bit of momentum, a little bit of a spark, and then maybe that'll carry over.
Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. That's caught by Montgomery. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. So the pitch and catch good for 11. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
Go ahead.
Throwing now is Tagovailoa. That is caught. And he is going to have a Rams first down, maybe by about a yard as they find a way to convert on third and inches. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Up the middle, it's Montgomery. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
On second down, Tua. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
Well, they certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they forced big turnovers already. And it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Solo left Zion. Solo left. Hey. Watch it, Oscar. Solo left Zion. Hey, 21-10.
Tua gonna throw. Oh, and Tua going to be intercepted for the third time. Down the right sideline. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. McPherson on for the point after. And that stretches the lead to 27. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. The Los Angeles offense set to begin their next drive.
Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail-biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
Here's Tua. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
11 MT, tight. 11 MT.
In motion left, Godwin.
11.
On first and 10, Joe Burrow. And that is incomplete.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
12. 11, Thomas. 11, MT, Tate. 12. 11.
Now Burrow to throw on second down. This is caught. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. Now Burrow going to change things up.
11 mighty.
He'll look to throw. That's caught at the two. He'll get only two there, and it's second and goal.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
One back in the game, that's Jones, second and goal. Touchdown, Cowboys! A.T. Perry with touchdown number 15 of the year and second of the game. And the Cowboys use the short field to get in for six. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Los Angeles offense set to begin their next drive.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable. Now, a win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
On first down, Tagovailoa. Quick slant, caught by Moore. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. First down, here's the run with Montgomery. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
He had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one?
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end.
Ball on the 36 now. Here's a second down and four.
21G.
Looking to pass. Tua. This is caught. It's Cooks. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7.
In motion right, that's Burks.
They'll run with Montgomery. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown.
David Montgomery with his fourth rushing touchdown on the year. And the Rams are able to cut into that deficit.
Sometimes you get a first and goal and you're back near the 7, 8, 9 yard line and you start thinking, maybe we'll run it here on first down to get half of what we need, so maybe we can have two or three shots at going for it from closer range. So this is a bonus right here. What a great run to work his way into the end zone.
Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
Here we go.
This will probably be the last play of the quarter.
11 mighty. 11 MT, 11.
First down, here's Burrow. And that one not to be, it's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. Back now in Arlington. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four.
On one, ready?
Second and 11, 10.
11, Thomas.
In motion left, Godwin.
11, Thomas. 12, 12, 12.
Burrow once again here on second and 10. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Jones. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
11.
Throwing now, Burrow on first down. Oh, and that is incomplete.
I think it's fairly safe to call this game over, but they're still trying to bomb it downfield and add to their lead. Almost makes you start to feel for the defense and root for them a little bit, too.
11, mighty. 11, mighty. 11, 11, 11, 11. Stop.
Again, it's Burrow. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
Now third down and very 11, long.
11, 11. 11, 11, 11. 12-12-12.
Now it's Burrow. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. A big play here from Dallas. And even 50 yards. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Now Burrow. Taken down here. A sack back at the 32. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
12, 11, MP, take.
Throwing on second and long. Burrow. And pressure coming, and they got him once again.
Hey, we're good.
Need something from deep in the bag 11, of tricks 11, here 11. After first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Burrow will throw. That'll be caught. It's St. Brown. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him.
11, Thomas.
Here's a first and 10 Thomas. At the 14-yard line.
Stop.
Off the play fake. Here's Burrow. And this one is incomplete.
A CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, if you're up, you can continue to do what you want to do. It's up to the other team to make you change how you do things. They'll continue to throw it around until stopped.
Well, they're up comfortably here, Charles, but that lead certainly not dissuading them from pressing the envelope late. I mean, if anything, with these passes, it's like they're getting more aggressive to try to drive the ball downfield.
And that will certainly lend itself to some post-game questions for that coach. And maybe you and I should attend that press conference to see what he has to say, because someone's going to ask him why he continued to push it. My guess, he didn't like how some of the snaps were running earlier. He wanted to use that as a chance to clean things up. But he certainly will have some explaining to do.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Perry. Only a yard on the completion. It's second and goal.
Here we go.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. One back in the game. That's Jones, second and goal.
11, 11.
Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. Buying time to his left. And he'll just chuck this one up into row G. It's incomplete.
Well, their passing attack, even though that one was incomplete, has been really sharp in this one. It's resulted in a lot of touchdowns. And it looks like they're not going to stop throwing the football until the very end of this one.
Well, that will certainly make everyone involved on offense pretty happy, because that gives them all a chance to pad their stats a bit. But as far as the actual need, you and I both know they can just...
And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
McPherson now for the extra point.
Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25. The Los Angeles offense set to begin their next drive. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out?
Ready.
This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
Going to the air, Tagovailoa. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Roquan Smith. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. From down at the 12, it's first and 10.
At the 12-yard line.
12, 12, 12.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. Forced out to his left. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
Well, up big here in the fourth quarter, up really big. That passing incompletion, I don't think they needed the completion, but Charles, this is an offense right now that they're just having fun. They're clicking on all cylinders.
Yeah, you're right. They didn't need a completion. They certainly don't need any more points. But they're not going to turn them down. They're going to continue to run what they have in their playbook, and they still want to run it efficiently.
And it's caught. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. On third and one, Burrow. And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown.
But not much defensive resistance on that drive. And really, Charles, the way this offense has been humming, they haven't faced much defensive resistance the entire game.
Yeah, I think it's safe to say that one team, their defense did not wake up and make it to the stadium for this one. There may be some major changes on that side of the ball when we see them the next time out.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Fair catch, going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25.
The Los Angeles offense set to begin their next drive.
We said it at halftime that they would need a nearly perfect second half to erase that deficit that they were facing, CD, but unfortunately, the second half has pretty much been a carbon copy of the first.
Yeah, that early lead was almost insurmountable the way their opponent was playing. And partner, they do have some good news, though. This one is getting close to being over, and they can try and hit the reset button starting tomorrow. That's coverage you'd expect to see in a tie game late. Not in a lopsided game like this. They are not letting up.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
Let's go. Number one, high. Eight.
From the gun, it's Tua.
Open man, that's Gesicki down the field.
Look at the big man rumble. And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late, but he does get in for six.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man.
Here's Groupie for the PAT.
His kick
And they make the score a little bit more respectable here in our final quarter of play. So it would no doubt be a miracle comeback from here, but let's see what they can do starting with the onside kick. And the Cowboys are able to recover.
Well, CD, you understand. I mean, they're so eager trying to get back in this game here in the fourth quarter, but they touched that one a little too early before it went 10 yards.
Here we go.
Brandon, in such a high-stakes scenario, everyone's feeling the pressure on this play. The special teams coordinator, which one is he going to pick in terms of kicks? Can the kicker execute it? Can the team wait for 10 yards? So many variables, and in this case, they didn't get it done.
And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down.
Stop, guys. Stop. 11, 11, 11, 11. 11, Thomas. 11, Mighty. 11, Mighty. 12, 12, 12.
Now it's Burrow. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
They are certainly not letting up on the pressure in this one, and oftentimes you hear this expression, all gas, no break from defenses.
11, 11, 11.
But in this case, it's the offense still throwing the football up big in the fourth quarter.
Second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I see a surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. And give him another six. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues.
And McPherson on for the extra point.
And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Xavier Gibson now from his end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line.
Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out-personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
21G, 21G.
Setting to throw on first down is Tua. That's going to be taken in by Downs. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game.
can't even get a playoff.
So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit.
Can't even get a playoff.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit.